just at the start of this tour, and how are you feeling about the first show tonight?
I'm a little disappointed because as you look around, there's nobody here. So that's a little frustrating because you work so hard on this stuff and then forget to tell anybody about the show. But I think, you know, we'll probably enjoy it anyways. It gives us a chance to kind of go through everything for the 7,000th time and wish that people were coming. That would be a great thing, but that's what show number two is for, hopefully.
As captain of this band of merry sailors, I'm a black mark, I'm a failure, but before you watch me drown, I'm relinquishing command for something I don't understand. This man's about to turn his whole life upside down. I set a course for a new show. Do the navigation on their own, whilst yearning for adventure, dreading censure in absentia. I would rather be at sea than be alone. I set a course for a new shore. It looked the same as the one before, and I forgot what I've been sailing for and why I thought this time would be different.
A lot of talk about this new band that you've put together, and so if you just give us an idea of, you know, how you found them. And
sure. Well, I mean, it's been a tough process putting this band together because, you know, while making my kind of solo step, I wanted to make all the right choices and I wanted to get the best possible musicians out there. So I did a lot of looking on the internet, you know, Craigslist, eBay, Twitter, and didn't have much luck. So then I started calling around some of my friends in the business. So I called Ozzy Osbourne. So, you know, I spoke to his wife Sharon. And said, like, who is the best, most kick-ass banjo, clarinet, and bass player? And they said, oh, we gotta go with Jay Baird. And I thought, I would love to work with Jay Baird, but I don't know if I can afford it. So I called him up, and he gave me this smoking deal.
Y'all just don't give up nothing in New York.
$40. I thought it was going to be pretty close to 50.
Thank you.
That's what it costs to get into New York City?
Yeah.
$40?
That's right.
That's a big effort.
Like we're never gonna die.
go to 400. Why not?
Don't start after.
No.
Jesse, I found through Paul Anka. I was in Vegas and Paul was doing his set and I saw him after the show, and you know, both being kind of Canadians, and we did a lot of hugging and talking and that kind of stuff. Jesse was hanging around backstage. He was playing with Paul at the time. And Paul just flipped at one point. Like, I don't know what happened. Jesse made noise or ate a tortilla chip and it just rubbed him the wrong way. And Paul wigged out, fired him on the spot, and I hired him right then. Heard Karen Graves stuff before or not, but she had a series of hit records in the late 70s, early 80s as a, you know, a disco diva, chanteuse, and violinist, and you know, hugely successful. And then, I don't know, strange twists of fate. You know, she married a man who took all her money and disappeared off the coast of Mexico somewhere, and she became a hermit. And the three guys named Baird, who were unrelated, and I looked high and low for her and finally found her and begged her to come out of retirement. And she's very reluctantly doing this, but we're very happy to have her on board.
Show. You know what my favorite part of this show is? The end!
Bryden, I met through a series of, we had met before, we didn't realize it because we hadn't, our faces had been disguised. Did you ever see the movie Eyes Wide Shut? It was kind of like that, except it was with trumpets. And but as soon as I heard him blow into his horn, I recognized it and said, I need that in my band. And you know, at this point, I'm doling out cash like left, right, and center, but it's worth it. Because this is what's going to take us to the top, is this group of people.
How did you sleep?
Like a baby. You know, woke up crying every couple of hours.
And then Finn, the last guy, I mean, I don't even know how to pronounce his last name because he changes it every day. I don't know why he does this, but I love the mystery. And he is kind of a mysterious man. He spent a lot of time playing in the Doobie Brothers, and was also one of the members of Kraftwerk. A lot of people don't realize. And ended up surfacing in Vancouver, and you know, he was running up like a little patisserie coffee shop kind of place. Had kind of turned his back on music, and I got him to come to his senses, and you know, he's starting to come out of his shell now. His playing is fantastic, and he was mentioning something about this deal with the devil that he has, which I guess gives him his magic powers. And I'm trying to figure out if he can hook up a meet and greet so I can meet him as well, because I've heard this guy like really, really brings talent to your fingers and your voice.
Basically, I got a phone call from the office, and they've been wrestling with it for a few days.
So, what did Cynthia say exactly?
Stephen had been submitting some tour receipts and found out, well, then Cynthia at that point found out that the band was purchased on eBay.
They know all about it.
I think it doesn't matter. If the band is good, the band is good. Whether or not he found it on eBay, Etsy, Amazon, it doesn't matter. You can buy cars on eBay. Why not a band? You know, I think management is just angry that, you know, Stephen thought of the idea of getting the band off eBay first. An eBay band is just as good as any other band.
Such a great band, but when I found out that they were bought on eBay, it was kind of depressing. But I understand why the tour's been canceled now. I guess I gotta look my old boss up. He's a petroleum transfer technician for a while.
You still respect them now that, or is it make
no,
it?
Not really, not anymore.
Cheap on eBay.
That's not funny.
Yeah. Jerk.
Well, we're thinking about continuing on the tour.
Oh, come on. Well, how are we going to do that?
We can do it without Steven. Yeah. We need to get
really?
Paul on board.
Yeah.
But we're all afraid to ask him. We got Boris.
Yeah.
We got Josh.
Okay.
We got Finn. And we got us three.
Okay.
We got you.
I'm in. I'm totally in.
But we need a front of house person, so you gotta go ask Paul.
Because the tour is canceled, like the band, like we're kind of strapped up, so we're thinking, could we just go forward and do the tour without Steven? Like we could, I know that we could make this work. Like we could totally, we'll just.
Well, who's gonna sing, Josh?
What about you? Like, is you, you mean you've watched the show enough times now that.
I've never sang out in my life.
So is that a yes then, or is it like a maybe at least? Like
it's
maybe
a,
we'll.
It's a no. This can't happen. It's not gonna happen. I mean, you know, I can't sing. Put Josh up there now.
What about Winston? Winston, I've heard him sing.
He has something there, but like I said, I don't have time for this right now. I don't have time for this right now.
Well, I'll talk to Winston, and then we'll check back in.
Well, you better talk to him. It's not good.
Take away from this whole experience, like this whole tour and people.
Well,
and
I got a couple of sexually transmitted diseases, so there's that. I lost a lot of money,
yeah,
a lot of pain,
Had an interview with, I don't remember who, but it was an interview of him touting that, you know, all these people, all these band members were amazing and played with really all these famous people. And now we find out it's all a lie. He lied about it.
Karen?
Yeah?
How do you feel about this being a farewell show?
You know, to be honest, I think the whole thing is kind of like an overreaction on the part of management. Like, you know, they're making a big deal of something that's really kind of a small thing. And it's unfortunate because there's a lot of people's jobs at stake and, you know, someone's career just for the sake of, you know, like, difference of opinion about what makes a good band, really. But I got other things I can do, I guess, you know, like, I'll figure something out. Maybe we'll just put another post up on eBay and see if something better comes along, you know? But it's getting hard to play the shows because, you know, a couple nights ago we're playing and Steven makes some comment about the props that he got off eBay and then everybody started booing. And it's just getting a little uncomfortable. Wow, those are really crooked. Well, it's the last show.
Hey, get out of my shop. Get out of my shop.
Yeah, they're here.
You know I'm not going out there first.
Diva.
Hello. Hello. Your boss is speaking. There's no fucking way I'm going out there first.
Okay, I'll go first. Okay.
I feel a lot better. I feel so good now. I'm going to go to the show. This is what I do each night, and I love it so. The music box dancer is rock and roll. I'll go my way.
Okay.
That's boring, so I have no problem with boring. She's cool.
Thank you.
buying a band off of eBay? That's the stupidest thing I ever heard.
Why is she going in there? You think she'll be safe in there? Well, she's got food and water. How far does she
no.
go?
No. Oh, Campbell.
Oh, it's fresh. Good job.